Hello viewers, in this video I'll be showing you how to make a bootable Windows XP, Windows 7 or Windows 8 disk. You may have bent an OS image to a disk, Windows OS image to a disk, and then after changing the boot menu or doing all other things, your computer is still not able to recognize the disk or is not able to boot from the disk. If you are one of such people, I bet you by the end of this video your problem will be solved. What we need is a software called Magic ISO Maker. You can find it on Google, or you can download it from the link I've provided in the description of this video. What again we need is the boot files. The boot file is a file that is needed to make the operating system bootable. So when you copy Windows operating system from one disk to another, it loses its bootable boot capabilities. So the best thing to do is to insert this boot file back into the ISO image so that they'll be bootable. Yeah, the same way I'm going to provide you with the links so that you can download the boot files depending on what operating system you want to make bootable. But in this video I'm going to use Windows XP, so the same method applies to all other operating systems. So I'll provide you with the links and then you download it and use it according to the disk you want to make bootable. Okay, so let's go. I assume that you have already installed Magic ISO on your computer. If you have not installed it, then you have to download and install. You just double click and open it. When you open, you go to your file, you go to open, and you locate wherever your ISO image is. Mine is on my desktop, this thing. So I'll double click on it and it will come here. Because it is not bootable, you can see that it is written here, non-bootable. If your disk is bootable, if you load your disk inside this software and it turns to bootable, then that means that your ISO image is really bootable and then you don't have to follow this tutorial. But if you're having this problem, if it appears non-bootable, then I'm here to help you. Okay, the second thing to do is to load your boot file, okay, appropriately. You're going to go to the load boot image, you click on it. And then below here, from bootable image file, the last part, you click here, and then you load your boot file. Okay, if you download it, it is a zip file, so you have to extract. I've already extracted the XP. So what we do is I'm going to use XP, but you have to be very mindful here. You have to use the appropriate boot file. I'm using Windows XP as a demonstration. I'm going to choose Windows XP, so I'll double click on it, then you click open. Immediately you add the boot file, it's going to change to bootable. See, it has changed to bootable. So that is essentially what we are trying to achieve. You need a boot file to make the ISO image bootable. So the third step is to go to file and go to save. When you click on save, it has been saved directly. So you close it and open your folder and it is here. Okay. Now if you want to be double sure that it has really been made bootable, you open your ISO software again, go to file and open it, then you find wherever your image and double click it. You see, when we open it, yes, it's bootable because we have made it bootable. So essentially that's how to make a bootable ISO image. Then the next step of course is to use your favorite burning software to burn it to text. I use Nero and I've installed it on my computer. So what I do is right click on the ISO image and go to open with. When I go to open with, you see I have a list of options that can be used to burn this image, but I use Nero. So I go to Nero burner room, I click on it and I wait for some time for it to load. Okay, my machine is really kind of slow nowadays, so it's going to load and then it's presented with the options. You choose as low speed as possible. So you go for I think this is the only option. I don't know. Yeah, this is the only option. So you go for it and then you just click on burn. Provided you have a disk inside the ROM, it's going to burn it. Okay, so this is how to make a bootable disk. The same method I work with, I used Windows XP. You can use Windows 7 or Windows 8, and then you download the appropriate boot file which I'm going to provide in the description of the video. Thanks for watching and subscribe to this channel. Bye.